If you've worked with Excel for a while, you know that within Excel you can insert traces. I can choose a location, insert lines, bar graphs, columns, charts, etc. Within DataLink, though, we do have an option to insert a trace or a trend, much like the trends you see in ProcessBook. So all the nice features you're used to in ProcessBook, things like dragging a trend cursor across and dropping it somewhere on your display, all that stuff's available by using this insert trend option. And the insert trend can end up trending a tag that you specify in the spreadsheet. It can trend a stream of data that you show on the spreadsheet that's got nothing to do with Pi. So it's basically taking advantage of the functionality that we have in ProcessBook Trends with anything that you've got already existing in Excel or things you'd like to pull from the Pi server and put into Excel in that trend. To insert the trend, first make sure you've selected the cell where you want the trend to appear. That's going to be the upper left-hand corner of the trend. And then choose Insert Trend. Now what this is going to do is it's going to insert an ActiveX control. We've implemented this as an ActiveX control. Excel is an ActiveX control container, which is something you could ignore, but that's just a little bit of trivia about this. This is how we've implemented it. And when I click on Insert Trend, it brings up a dialog box where I can specify the definition of the trend. Now what I'd like to do here is specify an array range here of what's already on the Excel spreadsheet. Now I could choose to bring the data in directly from Pi, and I'll demonstrate that a little later on. But first, let's just go ahead and select everything. Now, this is all my data. This can be data from Pi already, or it can be anything, actuarial tables, whatever. It doesn't matter. It doesn't need to come from Pi. It just needs to have a timestamp value pair, like we see, timestamp and then value. Now we can specify that the first element is going to be the name, if you choose. In this case, that's not going to work. I'm not going to choose that. But if you had this, as an array, you can also specify if you want to include all the cells in the array. Now that has the effect that if you just select any cell in an array of cells, then it'll select the entire array. In this case, I already selected the array. And then we can choose whether this is a stepped or stair-step plot or just a regular plot in which we connect the dots. So this looks good so far. I'll go ahead and add this. At this point, I can go ahead and use this, or I can specify other areas, or I can bring in data from Pi. It's really up to me. I think I'll just go with this. Now this turns on and off the markers. We'll turn them off for right now. We'll take a look at the end result. We get to name this, so I can call this my first trend. And then, if you recall, we have these value attributes, whether a value has been substituted or annotated or is marked as questionable by the interface. Those are things that you can display on the trend itself. They show up as little icons on the trend. And then we can specify whether this result is going to show up in a new worksheet or in the existing worksheet. I had already selected. I wanted this to appear right over here, so I'm going to put it in the existing worksheet. It will appear with the upper left-hand corner, there we go, where I selected. So there's our trend. Now I can go back in and define this trend and add other things. For example, I could change this so that we turn on markers. So you can see that's the difference between markers and no markers. And then I can also add other data. For example, I can add data from Pi to this as well. So to add data from Pi, there's two things I can do. I can either make a cell reference to the name of a tag, or I can go out and do a tag search. For example, I'm going to put in the tag CDEP158. I'll go ahead and search for that. And notice what happens when you click on OK. Click on OK, it shows up automatically here. Now just so you know, if you do want to just type the name of the tag, that's not a problem. You can just type the name of the tag you're interested in and click on Add or press Return, and we'll add that. And as well, you can also go out and search, as we demonstrated. So having done all this, I should be able to just say Finish. We're going to show some of these with markers, some without. Yeah, there we go. If you notice, the green trend has markers, and I did that by the choice of markers here or not. So I can turn that on and off. You see the different markers show up now. I'd like to demonstrate that one more time, and let's look at the usefulness of that option to select everything in the array. We'll use two different different trends for this. We'll use this trend right over here, or this set of data, and then we'll use this set of data. In order to do this, I need to move this first. Notice you can't move this by default. You are just by picking up and moving it. You have to choose the Move Resize option and then select the destination. I think I'll put it down here, and we'll go ahead and move it. So I'd like to add another trend and demonstrate what happens when we try to select the entire array using this structure versus this structure. So I'll put the trend right over here. I'll choose Insert Trend. As you can see, the default is to choose all the arrays or all the cells in the array. That works fine if I select something like this, in which the only cells in that array are cells that have values and timestamps. As you can see, we've selected everything, N6 through 030, and that works just fine. Now compare that, let me go ahead and delete this again. Compare that to what happens if we try to insert, and we're going to include all cells in an array from here. We try to add that, you'll notice that it does not conform to the format we require. Now that's because we have these values, number of values up here. And of course, the way to get rid of that, if you do have that situation, you can always hide the count. If we hide the count, this now conforms to something that will work with this trend format. So if I insert a trend now, I'll just select that, add. It conforms just fine at this point. There's a right mouse click option called scroll bar that brings up a scroll bar that you can use to scroll backward and forward. It's not showing us much there because we're currently looking at just this column of data. If I were to add this scroll bar down here, though, since some of these are looking at process data that's coming straight from Pi, there we go. As you can see, you can go back as far as you need. And it's going to go back to the Pi server to get that data. Now, once you're finished using the scroll bar, there's an option here called Revert. That's going to revert back to the default settings, to the settings that are currently configured for that trend. Another right mouse click option is format, and this brings up the formatting, just basically the formatting for all the different things that you'd find in this trend. This is where you can change, for example, the color of the traces and things like the number of decimal places we show the data with, as well as just some global options like do we put grid lines, etc. Now, I mentioned earlier that you can actually have these update in real time. That's going to be something that will work with the data that's coming from Pi. The data on the spreadsheet, of course, is the data on the spreadsheet. That's not going to update. So what I need to do is, first of all, let's get rid of, on this particular trend, let's get rid of that data that's coming off of the spreadsheet. So I'll go into the Define Trend option, and I'll just take this and remove it. And now everything's coming from Pi. If I go forward through this wizard here, we have the option to specify the time range. If I choose Enable Updates and my end time is the current time, then what I'll see is that the same mechanism that updates ProcessBook, you know, at the default intervals, is going to be updating this. Yeah, so as you can see, every 5 seconds this is going to go out and get a new update. And so this is now building in real time.